heart to rejoice and search for the Lord.
Sing to him, sing his praise, proclaim all his wondrous deeds, glory in his holy name, rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
Rejoice, O hearts.
Look to the Lord in his strength. Seek to serve him constantly. Recall the wondrous deeds that he has wrought, his portents and the judgments he has uttered. You descendants of Abraham, his servants, sons of Jacob, his chosen ones, he, the Lord, is our God. Throughout the earth, his judgments prevail.
Renovate our building in order to make it handicapped.
So I directed his attention to the parable that we just heard and told him that as people who believe in the gospel, we would do it for a woman. This month, as you know, the church and its liturgy is directing our attention to the so-called four last things, which are death, purgatory, heaven, and hell. And the point is to prepare us for these last things. And yesterday's readings urged us to get our ducks in order, have our priorities straight. And today's first reading, St. Paul wants us to focus on what is our highest priority in life. And it is our relationship with Jesus Christ. It's not observing the law. It's not doing anything else. Everything has to be oriented to our relationship with God in the person of Jesus Christ. And if we could remove the barriers to that relationship for another person, even one lost sheep, then our life would have been worth living. It would have been a successful life. So we are urged too to have our priorities straight and to know what is the highest priority in our life, to have a proper relationship with God in the person of our Lord Jesus Christ. As we continue our
blessed be God forever.
Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and thank God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise of the Lord in his name, our good of all his holy church.
May these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation, and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy. Through Christ,
right and just.
It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just. servant Francis, our Pope, to be our bishop and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your hearts, and all the dead whose faith will long have them. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and
Amen.
Amen.